cool.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to this All-American exclusive here in Fayetteville. The Rillabong Super Bowl is Lordship Alfred Hayes as we take a look at that filthy pig Skinner.
Really good. There's no way to speak about these.
You want some more descriptive adjectives for this guy? I'll give it to you.
Oh, you're very positive with that. I didn't know that.
What a matchup this is going to be. Wait till you hear the ovation for Owen Hart.
At least for a couple of more weeks, Alfred.
Oh, yes.
2 weeks and counting to the big one, WrestleMania 9, Las Vegas, Nevada, Caesar's Palace, the home of champions, hosting this tremendous event. It'll be Bret the Hitman Hart to face Yokozuna.
And I think it's going to be the shake-up of Bret the Hitman Hart's career as the World Wrestling Federation champion.
How on earth, Alfred, do you give away 300 pounds almost and come out on top?
Well, that's what I've been trying to figure out. I keep pointing that out to you, but you have incredible faith in the abilities of Bret the Hitman Hart to retain his championship. I don't know how.
You know why I think that way, Alfred? I think because when you are the champion, it's the opponent who has to beat you. You don't have to beat him. The only way you can lose the title is on a pinfall or a submission. You know that Bret the Hitman Hart is not going to submit. And you know how hard it is to pin the excellence of execution.
It is. It's very, very hard. But Bret the Hitman is a very aggressive champion. He's never gone into the ring just to keep his title. He's always gone in there to thrash the opposition. And I think that's where he may come unstuck against Yokozuna.
Well, he certainly has been defending the title an awful lot, in fact, more than any other champion in the history of the WWF.
What a week this is for All American Wrestling. We're going to see Kamala in action. Also, a special interview with the narcissist, Lex Luger. And also, we're going to have comments from Harvey Whippleman, that little fountain of misinformation, and the big, almost 8-foot-tall, Giant Gonzalez. How about that?
Well, I think Whippleman is shocked the entire world with his introduction of this huge 8-foot-tall, or nearly 8-foot-tall specimen, Giant Gonzalez, and I really want to hear what Whippleman has to say. I think he's got some really shocking news for everybody concerned in the World Wrestling Federation.
And hats off to Mean Gene Okerlund and Bobby the Brain Heenan, co-hosts of All American, for putting together a tremendous feature matchup. Undefeated Native American Tatanka taking on Blake Beverly.
Well, I can't wait for that one. I think that Blake Beverly is probably a very underestimated one-on-one wrestler. He's got the skills that can take him to the very top, but Tatanka is on a mission.
You know, we saw those two beauties, Alfred, wandering around the Big Apple there in Manhattan. The two of them together couldn't get locked up. Well, maybe they could, Alfred.
I think they could indeed. I tell you something, if Heenan doesn't get himself locked up, Gene Okerlund will certainly assist him.
What a bridge there by Owen, and look at this! The Rocket showing us what it's all about, outmaneuvering Skinner.
He does have those tremendous Hart skills, all inherited genes from the father. He was a great wrestler, and his boys are certainly following in his footsteps, maybe even transcending his footsteps.
I understand, Your Lordship, that the Hart family is taking a complete floor at Caesar's Palace. But they're going to need a floor.
They're going to need a floor. There
was 13 children.
Oh, golly.
That's just what they could count.
Old Stu had a lot of heart, eh?
He certainly did.
Look at this, a celebration here by Skinner.
Pretty
he thinks
sure.
He thinks he's got Owen beaten. He doesn't know he's dealing with a heart. Spirit.
It is
for want of a better word.
It will unquestionably, Alfred, be one of the greatest WrestleManias of all time. It'll go down in the record books, in the annals, WrestleMania 9. Unbelievable event.
Well, how about the Money Incorporated tag team combination
who are going to put their skills together to defend their tag team title.
Well, that's the other half of the big main event, the Mega Maniacs, talking about Brutus the Barber Beefcake and the return of the immortal Hulk Hogan. The price of admission alone, Alfred, that match there deserves it.
Well, I think it came as a shock to the million-dollar man, Ted DiBiase, and, of course, to IRS to have to go in the ring against two fellows such as the Mega Maniacs.
Neckbreaker by Skinner. Could be all over here. What a surprise victory this could be. Oh, he look at that.
Well, he was a little nonchalant there, a little cavalier. Oh, look at him smiling.
Big mistake.
That is, oh, so silly, really, under the circumstances.
You guys spent too much time in the swamp.
Something wrong. He was very distasteful.
Small package by the Rocket. He got him. Let's go up and get the official word.
Now